Greetings, fellow citizens. Today we are pimping our saber. The saber and the raven are the only ships with three size 1 shield generators. Default loadout are 3 shimmers, which makes sense because the saber and the raven are stealth ships. However, if for whatever reason we don't care much about stealth right now, for instance we are fighting NPCs, or we don't think that stealth is much of an advantage right now in the game, we can put different shield generators into our saber and make her much tougher. And now we have to decide what shields we want to put into our saber to make her tougher. And as always, Maloko's wonderful Star Citizen database is the way to go. And as much as I love what Malokos is doing, I think it's time we find this kind of information on the official page, Chris. Right now you cannot find much there, and there are a lot of errors on the official page. We are clicking on shield, and you can see all the shields, size 0, size 1s, size 2s, and size 3s. However, in this format, the information isn't really easy to read, but we can change this. Click on Shield Google Sheet. Now we can see much more, but I think this isn't easy to read in HD. So I zoom in a little bit. So size 0, size 1, size 2s, and size 3s. This is much better, but still not perfect. But we can improve this. File, download as Microsoft Excel, or if you don't have Excel, you can use an open document format. And open with Excel. And we have all the data now in Excel, and I'm sure this works quite well in OpenDoc as well. So if you don't own Excel, you can just use OpenDoc. First, I want to zoom in, and I apologize, I have a German Excel version. I guess this is much too small in HD. So let's go to 150%. Next, I want to remove everything I'm not interested in. And we take away this and that. So all we have left now are the shimmers, default loadout of the saber, and 4 walls we want to put into it. Let's compare. There are lots of data points, lots of values, and I don't claim I understand most of them. But I guess we can take a look at a few. First important one is HP the shield generators provide. One shimmer provides 1200 shield HP, one force wall 1876, so that's quite an improvement in shield strength. If you don't care much, or if you don't care at all about stealth right now, you can make your saber much tougher. Let's see what else is important. I'm very interested in the power consumption of the shields. And if I read this correctly, if not, please leave a comment. The shimmer uses more power per second in power base and has a higher power draw per second as the force wall. Shimmer 180, force wall 171. And power draw per second, shimmers 563 and force walls only 534. So if I understand this correctly, if you put 3 force walls into your saber instead of 3 shimmers, you shouldn't have any power problems. And again, if I understand this wrong, please leave a comment. So does this make sense? Yes, kinda. If we say that shimmers are stealth shield generators, yes they are. And shimmers provide less HP per shield generator than force walls, but shimmers are stealthy, then yes, shimmers could actually need more power even if they provide less shield HPs than force walls. Now, the next question is, where can we buy force walls? There are many lists on the web, I guess. I'm using Jack Axton's list, and the link will be in the description below. So, where can we buy force walls shields? Port Olisar and force walls 6500 alpha UC each. Well, that's very nice. We don't have to travel, we just have to spawn in Olisar. So, we just woke up in Olisar. Let's buy 3 force walls. We are going to Dumper's Depot. And use the console. Force walls, let's buy 3 of those. And we bought them. I want to test detection range. I want to test when the weapons overheat, if there's any difference between shimmers and force walls. And then I will shoot missiles and torpedoes at the saber and compare saber with standard loadout, 3 shimmers, and with 3 force walls. So there will be a nice table at the end of the video and a discussion. So, the first test is Saber in standard loadout with 3 shimmers and in standard settings. Nothing is set on stealth and nothing is overclocked. And I want to see at what distance I can find the Saber. I knew I could test far more. I could test Saber in stealth settings, but this video will be much too long and that's stuff for a future video. I just scan now for my target. Okay, now I back up a little bit. Looks like I found the Saber at around 7000 meters. I'm sitting in a Cutlass Black, by the way. Let's back off and see when I lose the Saber. This usually takes a little bit of time. Okay, now I lost the Saber. And I fly again towards the Saber. And I try to find her. Okay, looks around at around 7200 meters, I find the Saber. I have replaced 3 shimmers now with 3 force walls on the Saber, and let's see when we can find her. Well, I know that's her, but I don't have her on my target on top right. Let's see at what distance we can find her. Okay, it looks like 7200 looks like 7200 meters. No, she should vanish, yep. And let's find her again. I am scanning. Okay, let's say 7500 meters, okay. Now, this isn't a very scientific test, but it's good enough in my book for now. Looks to me like we can find the Saber with standard loadout, three shimmers at around 7200 meters and in standard settings, of course. And we can find the saber with three force walls in standard settings at around 7500 meters. That's interesting. And this is something I should really test more, and I think I will. I will test now the power consumption. Is there any difference between shimmers and force walls from the data we get from reading locus? It looks to me like shimmers actually need more power than force walls. And I don't have a good idea how to test this, so I'm doing the following. I have four Panda laser repeaters on my saber. I will shoot those until they overheat in standard settings. And then I switch to force walls and do the same. If you have a better suggestion how to test power consumption, please leave a comment. And you can see we now have four Panda laser repeaters and we have three size one shimmers. Okay, fire! And now we have force walls installed. We still have our four Panda laser repeaters and three size one force walls. Is there any difference in power consumption we can measure? I will fire the laser repeaters until they overheat and we will compare the time. And here we go, we are testing now the toughness of the saber with three size one force walls. I tested the saber in standard settings with three shimmers often enough, so I don't need to redo this. And I don't know if I mentioned this already, there's no difference between a saber comet and a normal saber. The saber comet just has a different paint job and a different default weapon loadout. And we are starting with one size one missile. Shields front side 88, stern at maximum. One size two missile on the way. Shields front side 78. Stern at maximum. And one size 3 missile. Shields front side 63, stern at maximum. And we are shooting now one size 4 missile. Shields 30 front side, stern at maximum and no visible damage. And to compare this with the standard saber with three shimmers, one size 4 missile manned, shields front side down, stern max, and an orange spot at the front of the saber. And we are shooting now two size 4 missiles. This was a kill for the saber in standard loadout with three shimmers. I'm not sure if we can survive this with three force walls. Let's see, fire. Okay. We survived. The standard saber, standard loadout is killed by two size 4 missiles. Well, we aren't in a very good shape anymore. Shields front side down, stern max. The front of the ship is red, the body is orange, and we lost the right wing. Hey, but we can fly away, I guess. Let's see what we can still do. Normal SM speed, afterburner. This looks like normal flight controls, actually. We lost the right wing gun, but we still should have three guns. Yep. So, our pimped Saber can take two size 4 missiles and still flies well and can still fight well. People who know me know what's coming. Since this result was a little bit unexpected, I'll do it one more time to make sure it wasn't just a fluke. Two size 4 missiles, one more time. Shield sponsor down, stern at maximum, the front of the ship is red, the body is orange, and we lost the right wing again. That's a perfect match. And we are shooting three size 4 missiles now. This should be a kill. I'm sure about this. And torpedoes now. We are shooting one size 5 torpedo. Shields sponsor down, stern at maximum, and I cannot see any visible damage. That's really crazy. The Saber in standard loadout lost her wings, and the front was red. And we are shooting now two size 5 torpedoes. Okay, that's a kill. And we are shooting now one size 9 torpedo. There's no way we could survive this, but we have to test anyway. Fire. So let's wrap this up. This video is much longer than I wanted it to be. All tests were done in standard settings. Nothing was overclocked. Nothing was put into stealth mode. We tested the Saber with standard loadout, three size 1 shimmers, and the Saber with three size 1 force walls, which have the most shield HPs of all size 1 shield generators. First, shield hit points, standard loadout 3600 and with force walls 5628, which is 56% more shield hit points. However, this does not mean the Saber is 56% tougher, because the structure hit points, the hit points of the body, of the nose, and of the wings didn't change. Still, the Saber is much tougher with three force walls. And next, we took a look at the power draw of the shimmers and the force walls, and power base per second and power draw per second is higher for the shimmers compared to the force walls. So force walls win, and force walls need less power. And again, if I read the data wrong, please leave a comment. I'm very happy to be wrong if I can learn something. Next, we tested detection range. This wasn't a very sophisticated test, but still we can draw a few conclusions. The Saber and standard loadout was detected by a Cutlass at around 7,200 meters, and the Saber with three force walls was detected by the Cutlass at around 7,500 meters. So shimmers win here. Next, I wanted to test the power consumption in a practical test to see if those numbers make any sense, and I didn't have any good idea for a test, so I just put four Pentalaser repeaters on my Saber, pulled the trigger, and recorded the time until the guns overheat. And there was no difference between Saber with three shimmers and Saber with three force walls. And next, we tested the ship toughness, firing missiles and torpedoes. This is pretty much standard. I did it many times. I do it every patch. So those were the numbers for the Zebra with trimmers, and here are the numbers for the Zebra with force walls. So one size one missile, standard loadout 82% front side stern max, force walls 88% front side stern max, so force walls win. Size 2 missiles, standard loadout 65% front side stern max, and force walls 78% front side stern max, force walls win. And one size 3 missile, standard saber 42% front side stern max, and force walls 63% front side stern max, force walls win. And one size 4 missile, standard loadout, shields down front side stern max, and the front of the saber is orange. And with force walls, shields still at 30% front side stern max and no visible damage, force walls win. And two size 4 missiles, standard saber, kill. Saber with force walls, shields front side down, stern max, hull orange, front red, and lost the right wing, but the saber was still fully usable. And force walls win again. Obviously, I don't test this on the saber in standard loadout, because the saber is killed by two size 4 missiles already. And now even the saber with the force walls was killed by three size 4 missiles. And one size 5 torpedo, standard saber, shields down front side, stern max, front red, lost wing and guns. And saber with force walls, shields down front side, stern max, no visible damage, and we didn't lose anything. Two size 5 and one size 9 torpedo are kill for both the saber and standard loadout and the saber with three force walls. In my ship toughness test data, I have now the saber pimped with three force walls, and when we compare the saber to the Terrapin, both ships have almost the same toughness now, which is really crazy. So the conclusion is, if you don't care much about stealth, and if my data is correct, there isn't that much of a difference in detection range between a saber with three shimmers and a saber with three force walls in standard settings. There might be a much bigger difference when the saber is put into stealth mode. But if you don't care much about stealth right now, put force walls into your saber. You are getting a lot of toughness, and you are almost as tough as the Terrapin, which is totally crazy. I hope you found this interesting. I hope you had fun watching this video, and see you next time. Bye.